Welcome to my channel. Today we're diving into the fascinating world of jet engines. You know, those incredible feats of engineering that propel us across the skies and beyond at speeds that would have seemed impossible just a century ago. But have you ever stopped to think about what makes these powerful machines tick? What are the different types of jet engines and how do they differ in their design and function? From the classic turbojet, the engine that powered the first jet aircraft, to the advanced scramjet, a marvel of engineering that promises hypersonic flight, we'll explore the unique characteristics and uses of each type. We'll delve into the inner workings of these engines, understanding the principles of physics that allow them to generate such immense power. So buckle up, aviation enthusiasts and curious minds alike, as we embark on this thrilling journey through the world of jet engines. Get ready to expand your knowledge and ignite your imagination with the sheer power and ingenuity of these mechanical marvels. Let's get started. Our first stop on this journey through the world of jet engines takes us to the turboshaft, a workhorse in the world of aviation and beyond. Now, when you think of jet engines, you might picture sleek aircraft soaring through the sky. And while that's certainly one application, the turboshaft engine likes to do things a little differently. You see, unlike its thrust-producing cousins, the turboshaft engine is all about generating power, specifically shaft power. That's right, instead of directly propelling an aircraft forward, this engine's energy is harnessed to drive other machinery. Think helicopters, those marvels of vertical takeoff and landing, their rotors whirring to life thanks to the power of turboshaft engines. But it doesn't stop there. These versatile engines find themselves at home in a variety of applications, from powering boats to driving generators, even pumping oil and gas. They're the unsung heroes of the engine world, quietly and efficiently providing power for a multitude of tasks. So how does this power-packed engine actually work? Well, at its heart lies a gas turbine, much like its jet engine brethren. Air is drawn into the engine and compressed, then mixed with fuel and ignited. This combustion process releases a tremendous amount of energy, spinning the turbine. But here's where things get interesting. Instead of using this energy to directly produce thrust, the turboshaft engine uses it to spin a shaft. This shaft, connected to a gearbox, transmits the engine's power to whatever machinery it's tasked with driving. The beauty of the turboshaft engine lies in its versatility and efficiency. It's a relatively compact and lightweight engine, yet capable of producing significant power. And because it's not directly responsible for propelling an aircraft, it can be optimized for power output and fuel efficiency. Next, we turn our attention to the turboprop engine, a fascinating hybrid that combines the power of a jet engine with the efficiency of a propeller. Picture this, a propeller-driven aircraft, but instead of a traditional piston engine, it's a jet engine doing the heavy lifting. That's the essence of the turboprop, you see. The turboprop engine takes the best of both worlds. It utilizes a gas turbine, much like its turbojet and turboshaft cousins, to generate power. But instead of directly driving the aircraft forward with thrust, it uses that power to spin a propeller. Now, you might be wondering, why go through the trouble of using a jet engine to spin a propeller? Well, there are some distinct advantages to this setup. For starters, turboprop engines are incredibly fuel efficient, especially at lower altitudes and speeds. This makes them ideal for short-haul flights and regional air travel. But it's not just about fuel efficiency. Turboprop engines are also known for their reliability and versatility. They can operate in a wide range of conditions, from hot and high airports to cold and icy environments. This adaptability makes them well suited for a variety of applications, from cargo transport to passenger aircraft operating in challenging terrains. So, how does this propeller-spinning jet engine actually work? Well, it all starts with the gas turbine, the heart of the engine. Air is drawn in and compressed, then mixed with fuel and ignited in the combustion chamber. This high-energy combustion process drives the turbine, which in turn spins a shaft connected to the propeller. But here's the clever part. Unlike a turbojet, where most of the turbine's energy goes into producing thrust, in a turboprop, the majority of the energy is used to spin the propeller. This is achieved through a reduction gearbox, which reduces the high rotational speed of the turbine to a speed suitable for the propeller. Now, let's talk about the turbofan, the engine that revolutionized air travel and powers the majority of large commercial aircraft today. If you've ever flown on a Boeing 747 or an Airbus A380, you've experienced the power and efficiency of the turbofan engine firsthand. The turbofan is essentially an evolution of the turbojet, but with a clever twist, a large fan at the front. This fan, which can be massive, acts like a giant propeller, drawing in a huge volume of air. But here's where things get interesting. Instead of channeling all this air into the engine's core, like a turbojet does, the turbofan splits the airflow. A portion of the air, called the bypass air, is directed around the engine's core and out through a separate nozzle, creating thrust. The remaining air enters the engine's core, where it undergoes the traditional compression, combustion, and expansion process, just like in a turbojet. This unique design, with its bypass air and separate exhaust streams, gives the turbofan engine some significant advantages over its turbojet predecessor. First and foremost, it's incredibly fuel efficient, especially at cruising altitudes. By bypassing a significant portion of the air around the engine's core, the turbofan reduces fuel consumption and increases its range. But it's not just about fuel efficiency. The turbofan engine is also quieter than the turbojet, a crucial factor for passenger comfort and reducing noise pollution around airports. This is because the bypass air helps to muffle the noise generated by the engine's core. Chapter 4, Turbojet, the Pioneer of Jet Propulsion. Now, let's journey back to the roots of jet propulsion, to the engine that started it all, the turbojet. This marvel of engineering, a symphony of combustion and thrust, ushered in the jet age and forever changed the way we think about speed and flight. Imagine a time when propeller-driven aircraft ruled the skies, their top speeds limited by the very nature of their design. Then, along came the turbojet, a revolutionary engine that promised to shatter those limitations and propel us into a new era of aviation. At its heart, the turbojet engine is a study in elegant simplicity. It consists of an air intake, a compressor, a combustion chamber, a turbine, and a nozzle, all working in perfect harmony to generate thrust. The journey begins with air being drawn into the engine's intake. This air is then compressed to a high pressure by a rotating compressor, increasing its energy potential. The compressed air then enters the combustion chamber, where it's mixed with fuel and ignited. This combustion process releases a tremendous amount of energy, heating the air to extremely high temperatures. The hot, expanding gases then rush through the turbine, causing it to spin rapidly. The turbine is connected to the compressor via a shaft, so as the turbine spins, it drives the compressor, drawing in more air and sustaining the engine's cycle. Finally, the hot, high-velocity gases exit the engine through a nozzle, producing thrust. This thrust, a direct result of Newton's third law of motion, is what propels the aircraft forward. Chapter 5, Ramjet Riding the Wave of Supersonic Flight. Buckle up, aviation enthusiasts, because things are about to get supersonic as we explore the realm of the ramjet engine. This remarkable engine, with its deceptively simple design, has long captivated engineers and fueled dreams of hypersonic flight. Imagine an engine with no moving parts, no spinning turbines or compressors, yet capable of achieving incredible speeds, several times the speed of sound. That's the allure of the ramjet. Unlike its turbojet cousin, the ramjet engine relies on the sheer force of its forward motion to compress incoming air, eliminating the need for a mechanical compressor. In essence, the ramjet acts like a giant air scoop, forcing air into its combustion chamber at supersonic speeds. Here's how it works. As the ramjet moves through the air at supersonic speeds, the air entering its intake is slowed down and compressed by a series of shock waves. This compressed air is then mixed with fuel and ignited in the combustion chamber. The combustion process releases a tremendous amount of energy, heating the air to extremely high temperatures and causing it to expand rapidly. The hot, expanding gases are then forced out of the engine's nozzle, producing thrust. The faster the ramjet travels, the greater the air compression and the more thrust it produces. This makes the ramjet engine particularly well-suited for high-speed supersonic flight, where it can achieve incredible efficiencies. However, the ramjet engine does have one major limitation. It can't produce thrust at zero airspeed. This means that a ramjet-powered aircraft needs to be accelerated to a certain speed, typically by another type of engine, before the ramjet can take over. Prepare to venture into the cutting edge of aerospace engineering as we delve into the realm of the scramjet, an engine that pushes the boundaries of speed and defies conventional limits. The scramjet, short for supersonic combustion ramjet, is like the ramjet's even faster, more extreme cousin, capable of reaching hypersonic speeds that were once the stuff of science fiction. Imagine an engine that can propel an aircraft at Mach 5. Mach 10 or even faster, soaring through the atmosphere at speeds that would make even the fastest jet fighters seem sluggish. That's the promise of scramjet technology. Like the ramjet, the scramjet relies on the force of its own forward motion to compress incoming air, but it does so with a crucial difference. Combustion occurs at supersonic speeds. This might seem counterintuitive, as slowing down the airflow for combustion is essential in traditional jet engines. However, the scramjet embraces the supersonic airflow, using it to its advantage. As the scramjet tears through the atmosphere at hypersonic speeds, air enters its intake and is compressed by a series of shock waves, similar to the ramjet. However, in a scramjet, the airflow remains supersonic throughout the engine, even in the combustion chamber. This supersonic combustion is the key to the scramjet's incredible performance. By allowing combustion to occur at supersonic speeds, the scramjet avoids the limitations of traditional ramjets, which experience a decrease in efficiency at higher speeds due to the need to slow down the airflow. However, mastering supersonic combustion is no easy feat. It presents significant engineering challenges, requiring advanced materials and precise control over the fuel-air mixture to ensure efficient and stable combustion. Get ready to blast off as we explore the fascinating world of rocket engines, the powerhouses behind our journeys into space. From launching satellites into orbit to propelling humans to the moon and beyond, rocket engines have redefined the limits of exploration and captured our imaginations for generations. Unlike air-breathing jet engines, which rely on atmospheric oxygen for combustion, rocket engines carry their own oxidizer, allowing them to operate in the vacuum of space. This fundamental difference is what enables rockets to break free from Earth's gravitational pull and venture into the cosmos. At its heart, a rocket engine is a marvel of controlled explosions. It works by combining a fuel, such as liquid hydrogen or kerosene, with an oxidizer, typically liquid oxygen, in a combustion chamber. The combustion of this potent mixture releases a tremendous amount of energy, producing hot, expanding gases. These gases are then channeled through a nozzle, which accelerates them to extremely high speeds. According to Newton's third law of motion, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. As the high-velocity gases are expelled out of the rocket engine's nozzle, they create thrust, propelling the rocket in the opposite direction. Rocket engines come in various shapes and sizes, each optimized for specific missions and payloads. Some rockets, like the mighty Saturn V that carried humans to the moon, use liquid propellants, while others, like the Space Shuttle's solid rocket boosters, utilize solid propellants. The choice of propellant depends on factors such as thrust requirements, burn time, and storage considerations. Liquid propellant engines offer greater control over thrust and the ability to throttle up or down, while solid propellant engines are simpler in design and can provide immense thrust but cannot be easily shut down once ignited. Now let's shift our focus from the skies to the ground as we explore the versatile world of gas turbine engines. While often associated with aviation, these powerful machines play a crucial role in a wide range of applications, from generating electricity to powering ships and even driving industrial processes. At their core, gas turbine engines share many similarities with their jet engine counterparts. They both rely on a continuous flow of air and a combustion process to generate power. However, unlike jet engines, which primarily produce thrust for propulsion, gas turbine engines are designed to generate shaft power, which can be used to drive a variety of machinery. The basic operating principle of a gas turbine engine is deceptively simple. Air is drawn into the engine and compressed by a rotating compressor. The compressed air is then mixed with fuel and ignited in a combustion chamber, releasing a tremendous amount of energy. The hot, expanding gases then flow through a turbine, causing it to spin rapidly. The turbine is connected to a shaft, which transmits the engine's power to whatever machinery it's tasked with driving. This could be an electrical generator, a ship's propeller, a pump in a pipeline, or any other device that requires rotational power. One of the key advantages of gas turbine engines is their high power-to-weight ratio. They can produce a significant amount of power for their size and weight, making them ideal for applications where space and weight are limited. Moreover, gas turbine engines are known for their reliability and efficiency. They can operate for extended periods with minimal maintenance and have relatively low emissions compared to other types of power plants, especially when fueled by natural gas. Thanks for joining us on this journey through the different types of jet engines. We hope you found this information as thrilling as the technology itself. From the pioneering turbojet to the hypersonic scramjet, these engines represent the pinnacle of engineering ingenuity, each with its own unique characteristics and applications. But our exploration of aviation doesn't end here. There's a whole world of fascinating technologies and principles waiting to be discovered, so keep that sense of wonder alive and never stop questioning, exploring, and reaching for the skies. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more aviation insights. Until next time, keep reaching for the skies.